feeling. You see, grace. Grace. G-R-A-C-E. Grace, you see. Grace is Christ. When you receive Christ, automatically Christ dwells in you. Right? Huh? You receive Christ by faith. It's in you. Now, listen to me. The Bible says grace increases as you increase in the knowledge of the word of God. Look at this. When you receive Christ, it comes, it dwells in you. For Christ to become active, strong in you, it has to be your personal responsibility. Everyday work. Those who walk with God and those who walk with Him every day, not just on Monday, they wait till next Monday again. You walk with Him every day because He walks every day. Am I saying something right?
Yes, sir.
Now look at this. The prayer I prayed yesterday took care of my yesterday. I need another prayer today to survive today. Because the battle of yesterday come with yesterday. Another friend want to come with today. You thought you came yesterday and pray for you, you fail, you deliver. You thought the devil will not set another strategy to get you. It's a lie. Why do we pray for people after their deliverance, after their healing? They still go back to their sickness. Why? Do you know what? When we pray for them, we so demand that the only way you can retain that deliverance, that healing, number one, you live holy life. Number two, you become closer to God. That means you have a personal relationship with God. Number three, you live in the word of God. Number four, you become a prayerful machine. Even all these things are not in place in your life, I will see your time. They will pray for you after. Who was minister yesterday? Or today? And the demon inside of her said, when she came to church, we prayed for her after her prayers. When she's going back home, right from that entrance, the gate, he will enter. I said, why? He said, because she's not prayerful. So it's not my problem, it's not the problem of God. My own is to lead you, your own is to take what I'm saying. I can't force it inside you. Are you hearing me now? The devil is not powerful enough to tell you don't listen to the word of God. Because you are the one, the architect of yourself. But I said you are architect of yourself. God is not responsible for what becomes your life. What your life becomes, God is not responsible. He has to do with everything about you. God is only watching you to see how you walk and how you make what He has made available. Perfect. If you are going to marry, God is not even responsible for the kind of man you get married to. It's your choice. If you buy a car, God is not even responsible for the kind of car you buy. When I come for service this morning, do you think it's God who will drag you to come here? No. It's your responsibility to sit and say, I want to be in the church. I remember back when I was in the school, some of you are students here, who say, I am rector. Look at many unemployed graduates on the street. Do you know what? When they were in the school, they did not remember God. Now, the devil showed them that after school, I'm not there. Even while you were in the school, I was there. When you came out of the school, I'm still alive. So Satan will allow them to finish their school and collect their certificate and give their paper. So, when they go to any office, look at this. It is a spiritual that controls the physical, whether you like it or not. You are wasting your time. Stop deceiving yourself. Some of you go to school and even study as you are sitting there. The demon and father are following you. He said, on this lecture of today, let me see what they will teach you and will enter you. As they are teaching you, the demon are following you is collecting what they are teaching you. Have you not seen some students that will tell you? He says, sir, I read. When I enter exam, I could not understand. I could not write. Why? While they were reading, they were happy. They removed God. They did not close God. That they were reading, they removed God. They did not say, God, plus you. Come and eat with me. They thought they are the owner of life. They have power over everything. So, when they finished reading, the demon said, since you did not invite God to read with you, let me follow you. As soon as they read, they get to exam hall, they sat them. They sat them everything. Look at your paper. Look at your script. Look at your pen. Right. Nothing to write. As soon as they finish exam, they come and what they read, they felt as if they can't everything return. Then they say, the exam is over. How do I write? They did nothing. Nothing to write. Why? You must understand one thing, that if you are failing the realm of the spirit, your physical environment, your physical life will have problems. Many of you sitting here looking at me, you have no foundation, you have no platform, nothing, you are not learning anything. I find no prayer is not working for you. Do you have prayer for you? Nothing is working. Why? In the realm of the spirit, you will not learn anything. Nothing. Angel have nothing to stand on. God has nothing to stand on. Spiritual life, zero. Giving life, zero. Holy life, zero. Nothing. You come to church like that. If you die like that, you go to hellfire. And you will know that what we are preaching here is true. By the time you start preaching, this is the same message to Makajansu and Bacha. In hellfire, you will know what we are saying. You will get them. At that time, it will be too late. And I say, if air is free, Bacha will tell you. I heard it, but I did not know. I did not believe it. Hey, it's free. Come and join us. Hallelujah. Amen. So while the prayer was on, the lady said, there was a time she traveled. The demon said, there was a time she traveled. She was coming from Benin to Auchi. And she was standing by the roadside. The man was driving by. The man was coming from, I don't know where the man was coming from. The man just stopped. And the man came out of the car. You know, all these men that are very, very massive, colossal, as in the belly food, the eat, money day, connected with cowboy and nobody guard. So the man stood there and said, where are you going? He said, I'm heading to us at the roadside. She said, okay, let me take you out. He said, can I drop you? He said, sir, yes. He took the lady, the man drove all the way from Benin down to Auchi to come and drop the lady. That testimony that all of them was escaped from Bokini. I told God, I'm going to pray until I'm out of yet. I'm going to pray until the day I go, I leave the world. So no full stop. When the man brought the lady back to Auchi, so our people came out, all of them were happy. Our sister, how do you know this man? Yeah, I was coming over with it. So that very day, the man gave our family member money, mother, and the man traveled back. The man promised to come back. Another day, the man came. When he was coming, he came with cowboy. Big. So when the man was coming, no one shouted that there, don't come. So when the man came, the man just entered the apartment. People were shocked. The demon said that day was the greatest mistake that the girl made. I said, how do you mean? He said, when the man came, the man was exposed to us. We knew that this man is going to help her. So as soon as the man was there, and the man said, Baba to the girl, we also say, Baba to the man, don't come back. Ever since that day till date, they lost contact. It's not the man, it's not in those days, it's not in Nigeria, it's in those days. But the demons in our father's house said we can never return. And that one of the demons said, gave me a prayer point. What was the prayer point? Anybody that bow, whether spirits alive or dead, that I will not get to my destination. I said, wherever they are, let them come, let them meet their day. Brother, look at this. When somebody walk up here to give a testimony, the testimony of another person can connect you. Don't think we are playing here. We are talking about testimony, we sit down. It's the worst one of you are serving God. If you continue like this, poverty, ash, finish you. Because it is you that will say give, you will not give. You that will say fast, you will not fast. You that will say pray, you will not pray. Even if they are giving a prayer, that somebody will be shaking, somebody will be moving, somebody will be hanging. You are laughing. They are saying, what are they doing? Don't you see your life? Ask your life, my life, what are you doing to me? Ask your life. Don't say what, ask your life, my life, see what you are causing me. And the demon said another thing that shocked me. He said, there was a barrister, a young man who wanted to marry her. The young man came to approach her. After some time, the man traveled on his way. Whether he was invited, I don't know. The setting man there was coming from where the setting had an accident on the road. He died. Then the young man gave me another prayer point. What was the prayer point? Every spiritual setting. See that? Now, what do you see? You give you prayer. No, see that.